There's a few things going on here, and I appreciate all of them. This woman's old, right? This old lady,
maybe.
Old grandma, old bag, just a old beat up Crown Royal bag filled with bones and dust. Okay. What he needs to do.
She's for sure a drunk, or she's for sure drinks too much.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it. Yes.
No, absolutely. But this is August Osage County grandmother.
You bet.
Yeah.
So you'd be surprised how much a drunk old bag like that can handle. So here's what he needs to do. To go up there and go, hey, I'm gay as hell. I'm a flight attendant. I'm getting it in. I'm wilding out here in these streets. Grandma, can you handle that? And she's going to go, well, damn it, maybe I can. You never know. He's avoiding that confrontation because he's so used to this is how she is. But the moment he comes out there, for lack of a better word, come out to her and go, hey, this is who I am, the quicker she'll appreciate it. Also, then he can cash that check. He has $100 in his pocket. Also, if you say, hey, here's my phone number, and you call the wrinkly old Crown Royal bag, they'll have the phone number, but now we've already established our territory here. I'm not to be bullied. So when you call me on some bullshit, I'm gonna pick up the phone and go, not now, grandma. And then if she gets out of pocket, you go, look, grandma, do you really want to spend these remaining minutes of your life talking shit to me? You got minutes left, grandma.
Oh, she's going to live forever. This woman, she's going to live forever.
The mean ones always do.
Yeah, the mean ones live forever.
She had quadruple digits at most left, okay, if minutes, right? Maybe 1,000, maybe 2,000 minutes left. She needs to chill out.
I think she's got 20 more years to stalk him on this planet. That's
you know
I
what,
think.
Though? I'll say about what Lamorne just said, I think is true. I think if this is the biggest stressor and villain in your life, you could just let all that go by just being like, mm-hmm. I'm gay. I am hoping to only be at Southwest temporarily and eventually transfer to United.
Spirit, if they'll have
Spirit.
Me.
Right. Yeah. But I think you just have to do this because right now the guilt's laying on you that she's old and that you're not answering her calls and, you know, you're wearing that. But if you just say who you are and then she's horrible about it and then you're not answering her calls, well, that's really her problem, not yours.
Well, there's this guy.
But someone doesn't know they're doing something wrong until you tell them.
Yes. Right. Well, she knows, but she's likes that. She's having fun.
That yeah, she might know.
She likes being mean.
Some people
that's
do.
What gives her pleasure. And sure. So what we're kind of overlooking is this horrible year that he spent with her in at a formative time when he was 16 or whatever.
Oh,
so she looms large in his life as a character. And so he takes all of these, instead of seeing her for what she is, which is a bag of Crown Royal filled with dust or whatever Lemoyne said, bones and dust and yeah. cat hair and you know, mini bottles. Or
she
whatever.
Has not taken a sip of water in a decade.
Absolutely not.
Just no way.
That desert skin.
Instead of seeing her as sort of a pathetic jerk of a person, he sees her as this person who will never accept him, purposely slights his sister by misspelling her name, or doesn't care enough to spell it correctly. Which is one of my favorite tricks that older people use when they mispronounce people's names or they misspell them and they just say, you're not important, you're not really, you know, that other person that other person you're also related to, your granddaughter, you know, the one.
Yeah.
You know, that they just dismiss their presence.
They just decide, like, I'm not learning anything more. Okay.
Yeah, well, she presumably has known her since she was a baby, but yeah.
That's
she's
true.
Just she's just turning the screw a little bit. She likes causing
Fun.
Trouble.
Yeah.
She wants somebody to call her up so she can talk about something that happened 25 years ago and why your father is no good and why you're no good and everybody's rotten, rotten, rotten. And then she hangs up. She feels a little better. And she swans into her room and has another Crown Royal and watches, you know, Unsolved Mysteries or whatever.
Write her back. Write her back and be like, and it should say something like, I hope I made you proud. You know, I think about you all the time and I did something. I'm just really acclimating to my job and I did something I've never done. And I would love to hear from you to congratulate me on becoming a member of the Mile High
the
Club.
The Mile High
and then,
Club.
And then put a picture with your legs fully in the air and someone inside you, and you look at the camera and you give each other a thumbs up, and then and you say, anyway, I'm cashing the check in as a congratulations in honor of my new endeavors.